Welcome to my media chops. In my video on the recap films, I asked if anyone was interested in a video that would cover all the differences between the original anime and the films, to which I got a definitive yes. Thus, this video was created. Originally, I made an article that covered the differences between the Code Geass films and the anime, but after going through it recently, I realized how bad it is. This video is an apology for that article that I will be heavily updating in the future. This video will contain roughly 90% of all the changes. I say that because there are so many little things I might have missed, which is why I can't guarantee that I got them all. So if you notice something, please let me know. This topic is vast, and this video is going to be quite long. So to help you follow along, I have broken up the video into sections. Narrative changes. These are changes with the story itself. This can be events, dialogue changes, and anything in between. Removed parts. Anything that was in the original anime that's not in the films. Now, if it's shown in a montage or reference later, that does not count as something that was outright removed, so it may not be listed here. New scenes. These are all the new scenes that were added in the films and their purpose behind them. There's a subset which are scenes that were enhanced or got additional footage. So it's not a completely new scene, but it is new footage. In general, there will be some overlap as some changes in one category might be related to another. I tried my best to avoid too much redundancy in this video, and the changes per category will be listed per film and in order of release. So, order would follow as Initiation, the Transgression, and the Glorification. Like my Code Geass watch order, this video will have timestamps so you can skip around to the parts that interest you the most. And this goes without saying, but major spoiler alert, this video will be dissecting every part of the Code Geass plot. In retrospect, this is the biggest dive into the plot I've ever done in any of my videos. I hope you are as excited as I am to go through this. And without further ado, these are all the most important differences between the films and the original anime. Here are the narrative changes that came from the initiation. The film starts with Lelouch's exile to Japan. The same was shown in the original anime, only it came as a flashback in stage 7 to start that episode. Colin gets a phone call from Lelouch in the shower to meet with him in Tokyo Tower. In the film, Ogi gets a phone call from Lelouch instead to meet with him at the train. So Colin never meets Ogi at the tower and instead, they all just meet up at the train. Colin in the bathroom scene determines that Lelouch cannot be Zero. This comes from that phone call in which Lelouch uses Geass on Sayako to call Colin while he was in the bathroom himself. The film removes this and instead, Colin comes to the conclusion based on Lelouch would have no time because he has to take care of Nunnally. Clovis's death is communicated through a public announcement instead of you, the viewer, finding out with the student council while they watch TV. The only difference in the scenes themselves is that the student council are not shown watching it. They reverse the order of events in which C2 talks to Lelouch before the soldiers transport Bartley back to Britannia in the films. This happened in reverse order in the original anime. During the attempt by the Pure Bloods to kill Jeremiah, Euphemia steps in to stop it by stating that she is a princess. In the films, Lloyd tells Suzaku when Yuffie was with him, but it was at a store front and it was not on a battlefield. In the original anime, Charles talks to Clovis at the Sword of Akasha after Suzaku joins Ashford. Like the scenes of C2 talking to Lelouch, they reverse the order here. Shirley's father and Lord Kuehl do not die in the Battle of Narita. Suzaku in the film is ordered to help Cornelia after she was ambushed by Colin and Lelouch. Originally, Euphemia ordered him to battle while Guilford was fighting Toto, which takes place before this. Lelouch learns about Suzaku killing his father at Narita when he touched C2 instead of experiencing her memories. Since they removed Ma from the story, this was their way of having Lelouch learn this. And after Suzaku becomes a knight, they remind the audience that Lelouch knew of this from that scene. Instead of the incident at Port Yokosuka occurring right after Narita, it is later shown in a montage of scenes. In the film, they replace that scene with an announcement that the JLF was destroyed. Detard, instead of Shirley, shoots Valletta, and unlike in the original anime, this event takes place after the event at Port Yokosuka. Changes were made to the meeting between Kitahara and Zero. Ogi, Naomi, and Tamaki go with Zero. Originally, it was Ogi, Tamaki, Colin, and C2. Everyone else goes to meet Rakshada at the Chinese Federation Embassy. This takes place after the JLF was wiped out instead of before. Zero meets with him privately with no deception or schemes needed. The Black Knights meet with Rakshada before Ogi finds Valletta's body by the Pure. Originally, they met Rakshada right before going off to rescue Toto. The events of Stage 7, Stage 8, Stage 9, and Stage 12 are shown in montage instead of real time. The Black Knights are introduced after the JLF was destroyed rather than the hostage rescue in the original anime. I know this because in the original anime, C2 discussed the Black Knight name with Lelouch while she was swimming. In the film, she instead talks about vigilantism. Lelouch says in the new scene that they destroyed the JLF in the Indian military district. I'm assuming they used that image from Stage 8 to instead be used for what he was discussing. Since Lelouch does not indirectly kill Shirley's father, Shirley never gets involved with Valletta and never meets Mao, so the events that led up to Lelouch erasing her mind never occurs. Instead, we get scenes of Shirley following Lelouch around, and she starts to suspect he might be in the Black Knights, instead of finding out that he was Zero. Tamaki asks C2 to get some Nightmare Frame training while they are in the sub when Lelouch was stuck on Kamina Island. In the films, Colin asks C2 to get some training in the Nightmare Frames way before Sokka was even made a knight. C2 is not with Lelouch like she was originally when he talks to Ogi about rescuing Toto, because she's outside watching Nunnally and Suzaku. Alright, let's move on now to all the narrative changes from Transgression since we just finished the initiation. Suzaku was chosen by Euphemia as her knight because of his demonstration fighting off 5 Nightmare Frames at once. In the film, he's promoted because of his deeds. We don't see Yuffie judging the arc contest, so she never gets the chance to formally pick him, hence the change. Instead of Lloyd meeting Nina during the events to celebrate Suzaku becoming a knight, he meets her at the school festival in the film. That's because the event to celebrate Suzaku becoming a knight was removed. Nina likes Yuffie because she gave her an award. Since Yuffie does not protect her during the hostage situation in the hotel, and Nina is still obsessed, but not to the same degree in the original anime. She does not, for example, show any interest in wanting to meet Yuffie. Egwene fires at Suzaku and Lelouch on Shikina Island, but in the films, Anya fires at them with the Mordred. I think they did this because in the original anime, Lelouch stated that the weapons were not finished yet, so they made this change to avoid a contradiction. Also, Anya is introduced before the events of R2 in the films. V2 never transports Colin, Suzaku, Yuffie, or Lelouch to Kamina Island. Instead, Lelouch escapes of Colin and the chaos created by giving Suzaku the command to live, and Suzaku wanders deep into the forest in the Lancelot. Later on in Stage 19, we see exactly what Lelouch did to Suzaku and the events that led up to them being transported to Kamina Island. In the films, we see it all one time, so everything that led up to Lelouch being held hostage by Suzaku, the command to live, and the aftermath. Since the events at Kamina Island did not happen, Yuffie learns that Nunnally is alive at the school festival when she bangs into her. Shirley's dialogue when seeing Lelouch with Yuffie was altered. She goes from saying this is no time to be hitting on some flirty girls to this must be why he's so busy. The changes exist because throughout the films, Shirley has been following Lelouch and he apparently is too busy for her, hence the line. Instead of Lelouch stealing the Egwene, the Chinese Federation steals it and repurposes it for the two passengers, C2 and Lelouch. Yuffie never got the chance to tell Lelouch that she knew he was Zero on Kamina Island, since that part never happens, so instead she tells him this when they meet privately in the Special Administrative Zone of Japan. C2 suspects that Suzaku could see her because of Narita instead of Kamina Island, since that never happened. Her dialogue changes from, "Just tell me one thing, are you?" to, "Do you know V2? The conversation between Colin and Yuffie has changed since Kamina Island never happened. Colin does not say, "There you are, you little puppet princess." Instead, she just says, "There you are, princess." And Yuffie never asked her if she was on Kamina Island. Colin instead just says, "I will avenge everyone." Cornelia is shown by the fireplace right after the scene of Yuffie dying. But in the original series, we see that scene after Guilford reports the riots are breaking out. Since Lelouch never erases Shirley's memories, she says, "I knew Lulu was in the Black Knights," instead of "What'd you guys do to me?" during the scene where Colin revealed herself as a member of the Black Knights. They actually removed the old conversation for the new scene of Shirley saying that. Since the events of Kamina Island do not happen, we get a new scene showing Lelouch saying, "Kamina Island, you mean the one that's near Shikina Island," over the flashbacks of Lelouch remembering the events of Kamina Island in the original anime. Instead of attempting to detonate a prototype Flaya in the Granny Maid, Nina is shown in the hangar crying because she does not have enough Sakuradite to avenge Euphemia. So that scene never occurs. When they land, Lelouch says it figures it would be Kamina Island. The film just skips this to asking C2 if she knew about the ruins. Jeremiah only fights Lelouch at Kamina Island instead of both Kamina Island and the Tokyo settlement. Lelouch has orange instead of stubborn ass, which further that this is the first time they have fought in the film. Later on, we learn that Suzaku was brought to Kamina Island with Jeremiah by V2, This is in place of Cecile saving him in the original anime. The entire encounter between Lelouch and Sasako coming to Island is shown in one scene. In the original, we see everything up to the conclusion in stage 25 and the conclusion in turn 2. Instead of Sasako encountering Bradley in turn 6, the encounter occurs when Sasako meets all the knights of the round, and much like their original encounter, Bradley also throws a knife at him. Zero states he will fight for the United States of Japan after re-emerging. He says in the film, the continuation of acts of justice. I'm not sure why this was changed. Charles and Vitu discuss killing God after the scene of Kaguya drinking tea with Tianzi. They swap the order in the film. The events of turn 8 happen off screen, and instead is referenced by Sasako when he says, how could Lelouch be in school if Zero was exiled to Japan? The events from turn 9 to turn 11 were not shown on screen. Instead, Cecile tells Sasako and Lloyd what happened in the EU, and since Sasako was in the EU this whole time, he was not present during those events along with the rest of the engineering corps. In addition, Shinkei's involvement early on in R2 is not shown either. Instead of Sasako returning to 10 classes like at Ashford in the original anime, he sends Gino and Anya to keep an eye on Lelouch. We see Shirley was upset during that scene, so Sayako must have kissed Shirley, but it was not during the Cupid Day, it must have been another event altogether. During the phone call between Millie and Sasako, they show the rooftop of the garden. In the film, they show a bird's eye view of the school. They did this because the bird's eye view is shown later after Millie starts Cupid Day, but that was removed from the film, so they showed it earlier in place of the garden. They made several changes to the scene of Shirley getting her memories back. Since Lelouch never used his Geass on Shirley, Jeremiah's Geass Canceller only undid Charles's Geass. They changed what happened after we see a close-up of Shirley with the Geass Canceller in effect. We don't see the animation of Shirley remembering everything from her past. We get a new scene where Shirley says that Lulu is probably in the Black Knights and Nunley is the Viceroy. Originally she says, I remember Zero and the one who killed my father. It's Lelouch. Also, since the events of turn 13 do not happen, Shirley has to make the observation that Nunley is the Viceroy in the new scene, since she does not find out in the train as it was in turn 13. She's scared in the original anime and calm in the new scene, since she does not regain anything as important as Zero is the Lelouch, the man who killed her father. And the new scene ends with Jeremiah telling Shirley to stay out of this, and that's what keeps her alive. Sasako heads back to Japan to the Ashford dorms after Lelouch destroys the Geass Order. In the film, when he heads back to the dorm, it's before the destruction of the Geass Order, and that's the first time he's been to Japan since the Black Rebellion. Originally, Rivel says that Lelouch is not in the dorm when Sasako asked him. In the new scene, he says he is. In addition, Rivel asks Sasako when he get back from the EU instead of when you finish your work at the government bureau to once again show that Sasako has been at the EU this whole time. Sasako fights Sayako disguised as Lelouch instead of Jeremiah fighting her since they removed that event from turn 13. Lelouch gives Raul the locket before they go to wipe out the Geass Order. In the original anime, he gave it to him while under Charles Geass before reclaiming his memories. Since they removed the events of turn 13 and turn 4, we never see Lelouch recruit Rollo or Jeremiah to his side. Instead, we get a scene that explains that it happened previously. They removed the part during the massacre of the Geass Order where Lelouch discusses killing Rollo for Shirley since Rollo didn't kill Shirley. Instead, later on during the fight between Lelouch and V2, they change the dialogue from Rollo, I will finish you off with the Siegfried, to it's time to part ways with you, my ridiculous fake little brother. V2 changes his dialogue from, I sort of liked you, Lelouch, because you remind me of Charles, to it seems you got your memories back, and you're like Marion. Sayako does not attack Valletta. Instead, she reports to Detard her findings in a new scene. During a conversation between Nunley and Sasako, she originally asked him if Lelouch was on the phone, but since that never happened in the film, they cut that part off from the conversation, and it just shows Nunley looking at him. To be honest, it was kind of awkward. In turn 15, this was the order of events. Lelouch confronts Charles at the Sword of Akasha, Valletta encounters Ogi, Schneizo starts the Flea test in Texas, and we see Sasako talking to Nunley. In the film, first Ogi meets Valletta, then the Flea testing starts, then Sasako talks to Nunley, and finally Lelouch encounters Charles. By doing this, we see the entire conflict of Lelouch and Charles at one time, rather than the original anime, where they broke it up with the above scenes that I already mentioned. C2's flashback was removed from the parts where Lelouch confronts Charles after the destruction of the Geass Order. So when Lelouch is rescuing C2, he says, let's escape from here and trap the Emperor, and tell me what your wish is. Originally, Lelouch talked about learning about what C2's wish was and saying, I now know what it is. Obviously, he can't say that if he never experienced her memories. Originally, we see the flashback of when Lelouch, not only and Sokka were children, when they walked between the dead bodies in stage 16. But since the events in the episode were removed from the films, they put that part in the film right after Lelouch was talking to Zaku on the phone, before he went to confront him, before the Battle of Tokyo 2. The opening of the Special Ministry of Zone was discussed after Nine takes control as Viceroy in Turn 5, and the films, the reopening is discussed before Lelouch goes to meet with Suzaku prior to the Battle of Tokyo 2. Let's wrap up the discussion on the narrative changes with the third film in the series, The Glorification. Since all the parts of Lelouch interacting with Shin Kei were not shown, we get a new scene of Lelouch talking with Jeremiah about Shin Kei. Nina suggests that Suzaku should arm the Lancelot with the Flea before Lelouch was captured by Schneisel. In this film, it occurs afterwards, and right before, Suzaku heads off to fight Lelouch at the Battle of Tokyo 2. This is important because since Nina now knows who Zero is, she's even more aggressive in her tone when discussing the option with Suzaku. In addition to the questions in the original anime, Suzaku asks Lelouch why he never told him about Zero, and Lelouch answers the question accordingly. The fight between Bismarck and Shin Kei is shown ending earlier than in the anime, which has the fight scene start in the middle of the conversation between Lelouch and Suzaku and end after it. The film starts it before the conversation and ends it in the middle of the conversation. After witnessing Guilford come to Lelouch's aid, Schneisel says, so this is the power of Geass. Originally, he said, now I have to believe in this power. The reason for this change is because Schneisel learned about Geass through the Code R project discussed in the initiation. The Valkyrie squad in the original anime is composed of teenage girls, one of them we know to be Marika. In the film, it's composed of men, one of them being Lord Kyo, who is Marika's brother. Instead of dying in Narita, Kalon kills him here. They show the scene of Shin Kei wondering why there was a ceasefire after Schneisel lands in Ikaruga. Originally, it was shown after Lelouch freaks out and Jeremiah grabs his nightmare frame. They did this since the freakout scene was removed from the film. Shirley hugs Millie during the reunion, means that Millie does not put her arms on Ribble, which changes somewhat the complexities of the scene. When Schneisel talks to the Black Knights about Lelouch, he mentions Code R and states how he got this power. Originally, he just talks about Lelouch's power and not the origin. Kalon does not speculate on Nali's death, nor C2's memory loss, like she did in the original series when she's with Lelouch in the elevator in the Ikaruga. During their betrayal, the Black Knights asked Lelouch if he used Geass on them and if he was Lelouch. This was changed from telling Lelouch that they know about his Geass power and that he was running a con game on them. They changed many parts in the hangar scene. They removed the part where Kento says, "Do you want to die with Zero?" when talking to Kalon. After Lelouch admits to being Zero, Ogi and Tamaki say, it's not like you to talk like that, just tell us the truth. That's a brand new scene, by the way. Originally, Ogi just says, so Lelouch you really were, followed by Tamaki saying, Zero! Kanon, not Toto, gives the order for the Black Knights to shoot Lelouch. Instead of the Black Knights taking aim, we see Britannian soldiers preparing to fire. Ogi pleads with Kanon to let Lelouch have his say. Kanon goes against this by saying that Lelouch might use his Geass against him. So then Ogi follows up by saying, Lelouch, Zero, please say something. And then Zero says to Kalon, you have to live. Kanon, as I mentioned before, he's the one who tells everyone to take aim. He also tells them to fire instead of Toto. We don't see Toto instruct the men to shoot the Shinkiro after Rollo comes to save Lelouch. These changes in general were made to show that the Black Knights never had any intention of killing Lelouch as they did in the original anime. When Anya enters C2's mind, now that Mariana's taken it over, you can see C2 walking in the opposite direction. She's wearing a blue outfit. But in the film, they remove C2 from that part of the scene. We don't see Suzaku discussing killing Charles with Schneisel. Instead, we learn from a new scene that Suzaku went off, and later on they explain the whole situation. When Suzaku encountered Bismarck during his attempt to kill Charles, Bismarck remarks, did you think you were the only one that knew about Geass? In the films, Bismarck says, so you have decided to turn on us, Knight of Seven. To add on to this, Bismarck never referred to Geass until that encounter with Suzaku. In the films, he discussed Geass with Suzaku early on, right after the Black Rebellion, so he can talk about it freely since the twist has already been revealed. Here are the changes with the scene of Lelouch talking with Suzaku, Lloyd, and Cecile about their planned thing with Schneisel. First of all, Nina joins them, and she's the one who talks about Flea instead of Lelouch. Because they don't show the part of Suzaku discussing with Gino and Schneisel about killing Charles, they discuss it here, and he explained that he hoped Schneisel would take over for Charles. Lloyd even points out that he was surprised that Schneisel even turned out to be an extremist. They also, instead of talking about the Tomo agency, Lelouch says the cycle went dark after going to Cambodia. I think this change was done to help explain how Schneisel tricked Lelouch that Nani was still alive, since Sayako was with Nunnally, and if she was captured, therefore, Nunnally was probably with Schneisel as well. Lelouch does not receive a phone call about the Knights of the Round because Suzaku defeats them before this scene occurs instead of afterwards, like in the original anime. Nina joins Lelouch after Schneisel destroys Pendragon with a Flea. In the film, she joined after Suzaku defeated the Knights of the Round. They don't show Lelouch's plan from the anime where he made the people threaten Nina only to save her and convince her to join with Lloyd. When Colin talks to Lelouch privately in the student clubhouse, he says, "Were you just using us, or maybe you fell for Schneisel's plan? Originally it was, Ogi told me to protect you with my life because you could make my brother's dream come true. They didn't do it that way because in the transgression, Ogi never tells Colin to go follow Lelouch for that reason or any other reason. Instead of learning from Suzaku that Pendragon was destroyed, Ayame Futaba tells us. Cecile changes her dialogue from discussing the dimensions of the Damocles to saying that the Totemo agency created the Damocles. Lelouch's dialogue also changes. Originally he said the Damocles was built by the Totemo agency, but instead discusses his plan to control the UFN before Schneisel acted, and added that the Damocles is a perfect place to store the Flayas. When Suzaku jumps on Jeremiah, he says, "Onward, Masked Knight." In the films, they omitted this line. I'm not sure why. Maybe it was to indicate that Lelouch was not going to die here. Lelouch's photo on the pegboard is of him smiling and looking at the camera. In the film, it shows Lelouch looking out the window, and we only see the back of his head. The footage from the pegboard scrolls up instead of down, like in the original anime. Colin starts monologuing as she looks at Lucia's photo. In the film, she starts when looking at the pegboard period. Shirley takes over for Colin during the scene of them running to school, in terms of the monologuing. Millie wears a light blue outfit and points to Nunnally's shuttle on the television. In the film, she wears a dark blue outfit and the camera zooms in on her. She never moves nor points to the shuttle, but she does make a weird expression. C2 at the end is content with how things ended up with Lelouch. In the film, she wanted Lelouch to honor his promise. I'm not sure where to put this, but apparently Shinkei died in the films. We never see this, but it's understood. I'm still confused because we see him as one of the prisoners at the end of the film, so I'm not sure when this happened. And finally, here's the order of everything we see in Lelouch's final moments between the glorification and the original anime. I'm gonna start with the original anime. Shirley eats a piece of tomato. Dieter Rhea is dying after Schneisel shot him. Lelouch using his Geass on Schneisel. Lelouch finding out that Nunnally is alive. An image of Nunnally sitting on that chair from the same scene. Lelouch kissing Colin. Charles putting his hands on Lelouch before he was absorbed by Sea's World. Lelouch encountering Charles before learning his mother was alive in Sea's World. Lelouch with Rollo before his death. The Flea warhead going off, and the Ikaruga and the Siegfried fleeing the scene. Suzaku kicking Lelouch's head on the floor when he begged for help. The UFN officially being ratified. Charles, C2, and Lelouch together when C2 reveals her wish. Shirley's casket with a flower on it. Shirley on the floor dead after being shot by Rollo. Lelouch closing his eyes as he waits for Shirley to kiss him when they were together during Cupid Day. The scene where Lelouch and Shinkei agree to work together after he lets the Empress marry anyone she wants. Lelouch playing chess against Schneisel. The Million Zeros being exiled to the Chinese Federation. The scene where he's about to use Refrain. Zero as he's taken by Colin when he's forced to leave Nunnally after the plan to rescue her failed in turn 6. Shirley punching Colin in that plushie. David, Dalton's son, firing at Rollo, which was part of his plan, Lucius' plan, to convince Rollo to follow him. Rollo with the locket vent for Nunnally. Millie, Lelouch, and Shirley cooking together at school. Charles with a visible Geass on his eyes. The painting on the ceiling showing two people of ancient origins holding hands where the girl is reaching out to the man. C2 reaching out to Lelouch when he's being rescued at the start of R2. Lelouch putting his hand on Rollo's head. Zero after Suzaku shoots his mask revealing him to be Lelouch. C2 kissing Lelouch in the Gwaine. a page from the book that Charles was reading in C's World called Paranormal Phenomena. Lelouch and C2 after the trap went off near the end of R1 at Kamina Island, the guillotine that they use on C2 that we see in her memories. Yuffie after Zero shot her, and we only see the zoom in of her face. Scenes of people killed in the specially administrated zone of Japan. Another scene of people being murdered at the special administrated zone of Japan. A mallet hitting Lelouch's head after Cecile used it too hard. The Gwen firing the Hadric cannon at the helicopters during the Black Rebellion. Lelouch and Euphemia on Kamina Island. Lelouch 20 thought Nully died at the hands of Mao. C2 and Lelouch making the agreement after he saves her from Mao on the helipad. Lelouch playing chess against Mao in the cable car. Lelouch kissing Shirley. Lelouch hearing C2 say her name in the cave when they were at Narita. The school council putting a cat costume on Lelouch. When the Black Knights first debuted after rescuing the hostages. The first time the Black Knights checked out the base that was their mobile command center that Lelouch asked a noble for. Lelouch threatening to kill himself when C2 threatened to shoot him in the leg. Lelouch as a child when Charles was threatening him, we see the scared look in his eye. Arthur running with the Zero mask on. Suzaku going back to serve his sentence even though we know he's going to be executed for Clovis's murder. Zero's first appearance when he saves Suzaku. Nully and Lelouch pinky swearing that he'll make a kind world for her. Lelouch killing Clovis. Lelouch changing his expression from fear to confidence and finally an evil grin after he uses Geass for the first time. C2 taking the bullet for Lelouch in that same episode. Then we see Nully as a child, Suzaku as a child, and Lelouch as a child. Okay, now let's compare that to what we see in the glorification. Suzaku, Genbu, and Kaguya when Lelouch first joins them in the shrine when he was exiled. It's hard to make them out though. Lelouch climbing up the stairs with Nunnally. Suzaku meeting with Lelouch for the first time in 7 years. C2 after escaping the pod. Lelouch and Nunnally piggy swearing. This is the first time we see their whole bodies. In the original, it was a close-up of the hands. Colin and Lelouch being interrupted by the student council when they came to welcome Colin. Zero's first appearance at Suzaku's execution, but a zoom in on his face, in the original you see the shot of his whole body. The same scene of Suzaku leaving Zero to face his punishment, but there's more color in this shot than the one used in the original anime. C2 with a surprised look on her face when she hears Lelouch say thank you. We then see the zoom out part of that same scene of Lelouch thanking her. When the Black Knights learn that Suzaku is the ace pilot of the Lancelot, Lelouch wearing a pink shirt when he said he would not use his Geass on Suzaku. It's a brand new scene where he discusses the idea with C2 and it takes place at the end of the initiation. A close-up of Lelouch's face from that same scene. Lelouch talking with Euphemia at the special administrative zone. Euphemia after the Geass was used on her. Zero shooting Euphemia, but we get a zoom in of the image. A close-up of Euphemia's face after Lelouch shoots her. C2 hugging Lelouch after the fact and reassuring him she'll be with him until the end. C2 getting up in the Gwen to kiss Lelouch. The original just showed the kiss. Colin finding out that Zero was Lelouch. Suzaku pointing a gun at Zero. Zero pointing a gun at Suzaku. Charles like in the first montage, but he made the contrast so bright you can't see his Geass. Suzaku holding down Lelouch. Charles before he gives Lelouch new memories. Lelouch giving Raul the locket from the new scene. Charles before he kisses C2. Suzaku showing his key to the Lancelot and expressing how he hates Lelouch for lying to everyone. Then we see him putting his heel on Lelouch's head like he did in the other montage. We see a different perspective of the Flaya warhead which shows the government bureau of the Tokyo Summit getting wiped out. Lelouch facing the Black Knights after they find out he is Zero. The Black Knights looking at Lelouch. Colin crying after Lelouch said she was his most valuable piece. Rollo dead in the Shikiro. Marion saying hello to Lelouch in C's World. Charles and Marion being absorbed by C's World. Colin kissing Lelouch. Nully from the video call on Lelouch's shuttle. Nully is then shown with Cornelia, Dietar, Schneisel, and Cannon. C2 holding Lelouch's hand on the bed. We see a zoom out part of that same scene. Lelouch using his Geass on Schneisel. Nully opening her eyes when she breaks Charles' Geass. Nully resisting Lelouch's Geass. Lelouch accepting the launch key from the Damocles from Nully. Nully as a child, Suzaku as a child, Lelouch as a child. Another major difference is that the montage from the original anime starts from the most recent event in Lelouch's life and goes backwards. In the film, it goes from the oldest event to the most recent. Now that we've discussed all the narrative changes, let's move on to the things that were removed. Now keep in mind, I'm going to keep this list short and only focus on the most important things. Due to the condensing of the story, so many things were removed, and this video is already long enough as is. If you want a complete list of things that were removed, cut, shortened, etc., the revised article will have those pieces of information once I get around to updating it. With that in mind, let's start with the initiation. The shower scene with Colin was removed. They removed the part where Lelouch gets a Zero outfit. We don't see Zero planning Sazaku's rescue with Colin and Ogi. They merely talk about it on the phone, but we don't see the actual planning scene. The conflict with the purebloods never happens, thus Sazaku and Euphemia never go to the Shinjuku ghetto. Cornelia is only shown fighting members of the Black Knights, removing her other battle scenes. The incident of Stage 6 to catch Arthur never happens in the story. Mao is not present in the story, so the events of Stage 14, 15, and 16 involving him and the consequences of that do not occur. They removed the scenes that explain Colin's home life situation and the scene with her mother at the end, which was Stage 9. C2's past is never shown when Lelouch touches her and Narita. The event where Yuffie was supposed to judge the best painting was removed, and her declaration making Sazaku her knight. Okay, let's move on to what was removed in the transgression. Sazaku is never thrown a party to celebrate becoming a knight. Nina never meets Euphemia, nor expresses any desire to do so. The entire incident at Kamina Island never happens. They removed the battle between Sazaku and Lelouch versus Atsushi Sawasaki and the Chinese forces. At least I think they did. During the conversation between Millie and Lelouch, it changes from people are optimistic since the Chinese attack to the Black Knights and the Chinese Federation are causing trouble, which was generic and could mean anything. Sazaku never officially declares his love for Euphemia and vice versa. They removed all the scenes of Ogi being treated and specifically the part where he tells Colin to go after Zero. They removed the Geass trap that Lelouch and C2 encounter on Kamina Island. We never see Lelouch get his memories back or anything else that occurs in the casino. It is referenced later through a conversation. They removed the scene of Sazaku talking with Charles at the store of Akasha. The hostage rescue is never shown, and I'm not even sure if it ever occurred to begin with. The school festival and the other events in that episode were removed. Lelouch's plan to capture Nelly in turn 6, as well as the phone call between Nelly and Sazaku, does not occur. They skipped the part where Lelouch almost takes refrain. Cupid Day never happens. We never see the scenes of Rollo and Jeremiah joining Lelouch. For Rollo, it was during the hostage rescue that was skipped, and for Jeremiah, it was turn 13 that was also skipped. Rollo does not kill Shirley, since she stays away from all this. Sazaku never interrogates Colin, since he was in EU the whole time. And finally, here's everything that was removed from the glorification. Besides the new scene with Bradley, we don't see him any other time in the film until he fights Lelouch in the Tokyo Battle 2. They skipped the parts of the battle where Shinkai is leading his men, specifically the Bradley scene, as I mentioned before. They instead go right into the part where Shinkai battles Bismarck. They remove the part where we see Toto, Asahina, and Nagisa entering the bridge of Ikaruga. They don't show the freakout after Lelouch thinks that Nelly's dead. Canon does not present the files of the suspected people that Lelouch uses Geass on, nor does Shinaizo play the recording where Lelouch said he uses Geass on Yuffie. We only hear part of Shinaizo's plan to use the Democles and the Flayas to establish order. They removed all the scenes of the Black Knights and the Britannians preparing and relaxing before the battle, including the creation of the Lancelot Frontier, Ogi and Vlad together, and the conversation between Colin and Gino. They removed Schneisel's speech to his troops before the battle between Emperor Lelouch and Schneisel commenced. They removed the part at the end where Nelly sees Lelouch and Sazaku playing the Requiem when she touches Lelouch's hands. Okay, we have gone through the narrative changes, what's been removed. Now we're going to end with everything that was added in all of the new scenes. Now this is going to be broken up into two sections. The first is brand new scenes, and the second is going to be extensions or remaking of old scenes. Let's start with the initiation. Lelouch and Nelly's exile to Japan is shown. The entire royal family is there to see them off. We get our next scene where it shows Japan at night and then during the day, which transitions to the next scene, which is Lelouch carrying Nelly as he climbs the steps of the Kudorugi Shrine. They animate the images from the picture drama of R1 stage 0.515. Clovis's death is announced publicly in a brand new scene, which shows the Tokyo settlement in the background. Ogi calls Colin, who's on the roof of Ashford. In the scene, Ogi explains that he was called by the voice from the radio to save Suzaku. Colin tells Oli that due to being too busy with Nunnally, Lelouch could not have been the one on the radio. Schneisel talks to Cannon in the garden about Code R, which was the project that Clovis and Bartley were working on. We learn that they wanted to experiment with C2, first to learn about her abilities before presenting her to Charles, but Code R was destroyed after the incident in Shinjuku. Suzaku learns that Yuffie is a princess from Lloyd and Cecile, and we meet Arthur the cat in the same scene. Shirley is shown following Lelouch into a store where instead of running into Lelouch, she sees a store owner who was affected by Geass. I don't know if she realized that. The Black Knights meet Rakshada with Father Lelouch in the Chinese Federation Embassy to receive their new uniforms and the Gekkas. We get a new version of Zero meeting with Kirihara in a garden instead of being at Mount Fuji. D-Tart shoots Valletta and later on shreds the documents that she was carrying that hid information about Lelouch. Shirley ends up in a ghetto area looking for Lelouch. Instead, she finds Nami and Kento. They tell her to leave. She has the same hairstyle from Turn 3, but that was removed from the film, so they used it here. Not relevant, but I thought you might find that interesting. We then see a montage of the events in Stage 7, Stage 8, Stage 9, and Stage 12 that were removed from the original anime. Lelouch discusses the Black Knights with C2 as he throws darts and she eats pizza. Colin in that same scene asks C2 to learn how to pilot a nightmare frame. Lelouch at the end of the film is talking with C2 on how to handle Suzaku now that he knows he's a Lancelot pilot. He explains that he can't use Geass on him. He looks out the window and watches Nunnally. Now here are all the additions to the previous scenes from the initiation. We get a new image of Pendragon that appears before the Line Fountain during the scene of Lelouch having an audience with Charles when he was a kid. They changed the background of the area that Suzaku zooms right through in the Lancelot. They also added new angles of the nightmare frame before it takes off. There's new footage of Jeremiah with the pure blood surrounding the transport where Bartley was in when they were transporting Clovis's dead body. Cornelia is shown landing in her transport before talking to Yuffie. C2 is shown outside watching Suzaku, Lelouch, and Nelly eating together. This takes place right before Suzaku is called to execute Toto. Let's move on now to all the new scenes in the Transgression. Suzaku is promoted for his deed after he fought against several Black Knight members at once, and that starts the film. Lelouch is shown traveling down an elevator to grab his Zero helmet, which he keeps locked up in a secret location. In this scene, Lelouch says that he gains his knowledge that Suzaku killed his father against him. What's interesting is that Lelouch says he might have also done this for Nunnally, and what I'm referring to is Suzaku killing his father. That is because we learn in the audio drama Stage 0.521 that Genbu was going to marry Nunnally for political reasons, so Suzaku was protecting her as well. I like how they brought that up here. Anya is shown in the Avalon firing at Lelouch and Suzaku from the Mordred. We also get an additional scene of her talking to Schneisel on pursuing them. Lloyd and Cecile learn that the Lancelot is back online, and we see Suzaku in the middle of the forest. Lelouch is running on the Garden Mark II as he and Colin escape. Schneisel discusses the ruins on Kamina Island and that the Gawain was stolen by the Chinese Federation. This is mentioned here since the events of Kamina Island did not happen in the film. In addition to this, Schneisel explains to Cannon why Suzaku was not punished for helping Lelouch escape. Schneisel runs the unit that Suzaku is a part of, and he is Euphemia's knight. Schneisel also speculates that he might be working for the Black Knights since they didn't kill him. This is important because it helps explain his action later on when he sets up Suzaku to capture Lelouch. Also, when Lelouch flees with Colin, he also suspects the plan against him was related to Suzaku. C2 plays with Cheese-kun and Lelouch asks for the contract terms and he gets denied. The Gawain is introduced by Rakshada. She states they'll add two spots for Lelouch and that girl being C2. She explains that it was captured in Tanzia by the Chinese Federation. Everyone in the Black Knight's base are shown reacting to the announcement of the specially administrated zone. As I mentioned earlier, since the events of Kamina Island are omitted, we get new scenes of Lelouch saying, "Kamina Island, you mean the one next to Shikan Island." We get a new version of Jeremiah flying to Siegfried, since the first time we saw it was when he engaged in combat against Lelouch, but in this film he only fights him at Kamina Island, so they had to make the change. Nina says she does not have enough Sakuradite while she was working on the bomb to avenge Euphemia instead of actually going out and trying to use it like in the original anime. Schneisel announced that the riots have ended now that the Black Knights have been defeated. Nunnally is shown with Charles and V2, and Charles says he'll talk to her After this is done, NV2 mentions that Suzaku captured Zero. Deitar and Kaguya are leaving the battlefield and telling people to flee. Count flees in her nightmare frame, she screams and it gets covered up. Situ's body is shown floating in the water after defeating Jeremiah. We see the moon and it darkens as the earth rotates. Suzaku is shown after this staring out into the sky. Nunnally is being shown transport to Britannia, and the story is she was rescued from Kyoto by Lord Kyol and Kolaris with the help of the Statfeld family, which is Colin Britannian's last name. Suzaku meets all the members of the Knights of the Round. Cannon picks up Nina after her recommendation from Aloyd is approved. Bismarck, Rollo, Letta, and Suzaku talk about Geass and the plans for Lelouch going forward. Bismarck explains to Charles that he had to lie to Suzaku about why they overwrote everyone's memories at Ashford Academy. Rollo in the next scene says there's nothing to report and Lelouch needs gambling money. After this briefing with Suzaku, he heads to the EU. Situ is shown swimming in the water with a weird expression on her face. Later on, Suzaku confronts Bismarck, why are they hiding Zero's identity, but he does not answer him. This scene exists because originally Suzaku confronted Lelouch at Ashford with the phone call between turn 5 and 6, but they removed that from the films, so Bismarck says to wait for the OS report before heading to Japan. Alicia explains to Nelly, now the Viceroy, that she cannot see Lelouch because he has amnesia and that could cause problems. They added this scene since Nelly became Viceroy in turn 5, and they removed all level scenes from that episode. This scene implies that Nelly knows where Lelouch is when she didn't in the original anime. Suzaku is shown on the plane Camelot, trying to figure out how Lelouch can be at school and at the Chinese Federation at the same time. It summarizes the events of Turn 8. We get more footage of Suzaku fighting the EU. This replaces the scene of him fighting the EU from Turn 3. Loi, Cecile, and Suzaku discuss that Odysseus and Empress Tianzi's marriage was called off. They discuss how Khan was captured along with the Gurren, and the Black Knights have joined with Li Shinkei. This is how they get around not showing the scenes from turn 9, 10, and 11. During a phone conversation, Gino tells Suzaku that Rival took over as the president when Millie graduated, and Gino sees no signs of Lelouch doing anything weird, plus we see Suzaku traveling somewhere, and we then get a part where Gino says he thought he had seen Colin before. We originally saw this when Gino sees Colin during the chess scene, but they took that part out. Rollo tells Suzaku that Lelouch is normal, and I guess this is how we know Rollo is working with Lelouch, since Suzaku notes he has never seen him smile like that before. Shirley, after getting her memories, notes how Lulu is probably in the Black Knights and Nelly is the Viceroy. Jeremiah explains to Shirley in that same scene that now she has her memories back, she should stay out of this. After Jeremiah is done talking with Shirley, we see V2 explain that Jeremiah is concerned for both the children of Marianne and he needs to find Lulu to learn if he is Zero and to get back C2. Suzaku is on a plane talking to Rollo about how V2 took him to Kamina Island with Jeremiah. Suzaku also figures out that the Emperor and V2 are just using him. Suzaku heads to Ashford Academy to fight Lelouch, only to instead fight Saiko disguised as Lelouch. During this new scene, they read and animated the part of Suzaku talking to Rival. Lelouch gives Rollo a locket for his birthday, knowing that he's not his real brother. They also talk about how Rollo should not kill Suzaku. Rollo brings up the idea of killing Suzaku now because he just arrived in Japan. In the original anime, Suzaku is in Japan early on in R2, and Rollo asked this much earlier. And this happens on their way to wipe out the Geass Order. C2, Lelouch, and Jeremiah are talking privately. Lelouch says he got Rollo to join by making him feel useful. Jeremiah reveals that he would have joined anyway if Lelouch revealed his identity to him earlier. C2 says that she kissed Lelouch to save his memories, so she kissed him at the casino, we just never saw it. We also see Lelouch taking off his Geass contact lenses, so that scene also happened from the original series. Also, Lelouch expressed that he's pissed off that C2 never discussed Charles' powers, but she says he never asked, plus V2 gave him that Geass power. They have to have that part because they don't show anything from the casino scene. One more thing about this scene, because they removed the part where C2 tells Lelouch that the one who gave Charles Geass is called V2, C2 says his name in this scene. Suzaku is marching forward and expressing how angry he is at Lelouch for lying and for C2 removing Charles Geass from Lelouch. We get our first scene with Ikaruga since turn 9 to 11 were skipped. We see Deitar discussing with Sayako how he will deal with Ogi and to leave Lelouch out of it. We get new footage of the airships flying over Suzaku while he's talking with Lelouch. The film ends with Suzaku sitting on a chair, thinking about Yuffie as he decides what to do, and they explain that the Special Administrative Zone Japan is going to be reopened. Now here's all the additions to the previous scenes from the Transgression. Lloyd talks to Nina about the award that Yuffie gave her. This is a combination of the old scene with new touch-ups since the circumstances are different. When Lelouch uses his Geass on Suzaku, they have a new scene of him reacting to the command. We see another perspective of the Avalon above the spot where the Mordred fired. Yuffie is shown reacting when she realized that Nunley was alive this whole time. This occurs after she ran into her during the school festival. While Yuffie's talking with Nunley, we get this extra part where they add the teacup, and they mention that Ashford family took them in. In the original anime, Lelouch told Colin this during the shower scene, but they removed it from the films, so they put that little information here in this scene. Lelouch asked Yuffie if he could meet Cornelia when they were staying during the festival. My theory behind this scene is, since Lelouch never met Yuffie on Kamina Island, he does not know that Yuffie knows he is Zero. Therefore, Lelouch would not think Yuffie would be suspicious of the request. In the original anime, since she knew Lelouch was Zero, and Lelouch knew that as well, he knew he couldn't get away with it. Yuffie tells Lelouch that she knew he was always Zero when they were talking privately in the G1 base in the Special Administrative Zone. They had to add this part because of what I said in my last point. They changed the scene of Shirley reacting to Colin's reveal as a member of the Black Knights. A new scene replaces the part where Shirley asked what they do to her. Now she just says, "I knew Lulu was in the Black Knights." Shinkei contacts the Black Knights and lets them know that if they take the Government Bureau, Gohai will help them out. I think they put that scene here because we don't have the scenes from Turn 1 and Turn 2 where Gohai helps out the Black Knights. I also wonder that if he was helping them out this time without being commanded by Lelouch, which he was in the original anime. When Suzaku was talking with Millie about not being able to attend her graduation, the wall color was changed from yellow to white and more details were added. And finally, here are all the brand new scenes from the Glorification. The film starts with C2 roaming around the Ikaruga, now her memory is gone. Lelouch discusses Shinkei with Jeremiah and the Shinkiro. Jeremiah then talks to Rallo and Sayako about Lelouch adding on his own to infiltrate the defense of the Tokyo settlement. Jeremiah tells Rolo that he'll have to rescue Nunley as well. We see Shinkei get into the Shenhu. If I'm not mistaken, this is the first time we see that nightmare frame since everything else from the Chinese Federation was removed up to this point. They have a new scene of Rolo, Sayako, and other Black Knight members heading over to the Government Bureau. It's similar to the original anime, only they're walking by the train turnstile and not outside. They made this change because originally they left during the daytime before Lelouch was captured, but in the film they left towards the evening, which was after he was captured, so for continuity's sake, they're shown underground. There's a new version of Nia discussing the flare with Suzaku. As I said earlier, it occurs after Lelouch was captured and right before Suzaku heads off to fight the Black Knights at the Battle of Tokyo 2. Shirley and Rival are shown in the Ashford Academy in an underground area during the Battle of Tokyo 2. Colin kills Kyo Sodorsi and another male member of the Valkyrie squad. Oki talks to Dieter privately, which results in him punching him in the face for declaring Zero dead without consulting him. This new scene is important because in the original series, Dieter is shown with a black eye, but we never saw where he got that from. Lloyd, Cecile, and Nina talk on the roof of a building and discuss how Suzaku left, but they have no idea where he went. Shirley's playing a school festival with the new president, Rival. She gets a call from Lelouch, and Shirley tells him that she'll help him out no matter what. She also talks about Jeremiah and Nunley. The point of this is to bring up that Shirley could play into things later on, and she does. Millie tells everyone at the TV station that Lelouch has announced that he will join the UFN. Originally, Lelouch made the announcement after Suzaku defeated the Knights of the Round, but they changed the order of events, so Lelouch talks to Suzaku after, not before, hence, they need another way to find a way to announce him coming to join the UFN. C2 and Shirley meet for the first time, where Shirley sees her from a distance. This is the setup for Lelouch of the Resurrection. We see the members of the UFN preparing to lock Zero to protect themselves against the Geass. Suzaku's arrival to save Lelouch is a new scene. In addition, Kaguya calls Suzaku a fiend. Ogi asks Tamaki why Lelouch took everyone's hostage. We also learn in this scene about the Flaya being used on Pendragon. They added a new scene where we see the Lance of Hygrel piloted by Alderaan Zephon from Oz of the Reflection, which was a nice callback. We get a new scene with C2 on a donkey traveling somewhere. She discusses that Shirley and Jeremiah delivered her a note. C2 then discusses if she should wait for Lelouch to fulfill her promise, or should she just wander through time. The film ends with a shot of Zero's mask in the water at a beach with the words, "Up next, Resurrection." And here are all the new additions to the old scenes. After the aftermath of the Flaya, Shirley is shown with Rival greeting Millie. Not to be redundant, but during the betrayal, they change Ogi's dialogue to ask Lelouch to tell the truth. Kanan is shown ordering the killing of Lelouch. We then see both Ogi and Tamaki asking Zero to say something. Instead of the Black Knights, Britannian soldiers are shown preparing to shoot him. During the scenes where Lelouch talks to Zaku about the Zero Requiem, Nina is seen with Lloyd and C2 arriving on horses. Nina then discusses the Flaya instead of Lelouch. We see Shirley watching Lelouch's announcement of him taking over the world. Shirley is shown later with the rest of her family as they watch Zero kill Lelouch. When Suzaku as Zero leaps towards Lelouch, we see a close-up of Suzaku and specifically the hilt that holds his sword. Shirley joins Colin as she heads to school. I'm still confused why they changed Millie's outfit from the light blue to dark blue and changed her mannerism in the scene from the original. And there you have it. That is every single major change between the films and the original anime. If you stuck out this long for the video, I appreciate it. This video was a challenge to make. Had to think a lot of different ideas at once, try to put it all together. It was not an easy process. And the most frustrating part is, next week I'll figure out that I missed something, or someone's gonna point out something that was so obvious, I'm not sure how I missed it. But that's just how it is, and regardless, I wanna get the video out here for you guys. If you liked the video and you want more Code Geass content, please check my blog. I'm finishing my anime guide. I kinda took a break from that to get this video out. I think this was more important. But either way, it will be out soon. I normally don't ask this, but if you enjoy the content, please subscribe. I'm close to getting to 1,000 subscribers. I'll let you hit that sooner than later. I'd like to know now from you guys, what was your favorite changes from the original series that you liked the most, or did you hate all of them? Let me know. What do you think of this video and the way I did it? Was it good, bad? I love all the type of feedback you guys can offer, because that's how I know how I can improve in the future in more of my videos. And remember, the world is not a dark place, and tomorrow will be a good day. Thanks for watching.